Hello. This video is produced by Ignacio Barrero, Technical Marketing at Dell Technologies. In this video, I will present what is new for Dell Apex Cloud Platform for Microsoft Azure in our early March 2024 release. We have structured the content in three main topics: new features for the platform, with a special focus on the introduction of Azure Stack HCI OS 23H2. ACP Foundation software enhancements for day one and day two operations, and two new integrations, namely Azure Event Monitoring for Insights and Azure Update Manager. Let's start with the new features Dell Technologies has added to the platform. The most significant update in this release is the support for Azure Stack HCI version 23H2. It is important to remember that back in September 2023, we officially released Dell Apex Cloud Platform for Microsoft Azure, the first offering in the market for premier solutions for Microsoft Azure Stack HCI. Now again, as a member of this elite premier solutions category, Dell is the first to enable 23H2 for new deployments. You can engage Dell and Microsoft support and services to provide a white glove experience for new 23H2 cluster implementations. Azure Stack HCI version 23H2 provides all the Azure Arc infrastructure needed. This means that right out of the box, you're ready to start provisioning Arc-enabled virtual machines, Azure Kubernetes service clusters, and Azure Virtual Desktop session hosts. Azure Kubernetes Service is a managed Kubernetes solution that runs locally at the edge and is now set up automatically as part of deploying Azure Stack HCI. Similarly, right after 23H2 is deployed, the AVD service is available and you can begin creating Windows 10 and Windows 11 single and multi-session host VMs across all your Azure Stack HCI clusters. To learn more in detail about all the feature updates included in Azure Stack HCI version 23H2, use the following QR codes to get access to additional learning materials on Microsoft's Learn site and from our Dell InfoHub blogs. In addition to the 23H2 update, there are a couple of very interesting new ACP for Azure features in this release. It is now possible to expand a single node cluster to a two node cluster. This is a Dell Services led manual process that will convert a single node cluster into a two node cluster that is configured to use the switchless or switched storage network topology. You can now also convert a two node switchless storage network cluster to a switched storage network topology. This process requires approval from Dell, and customers should work with their Dell account team to proceed. Once approved, Dell Services will convert the two-node cluster from a switchless storage network topology to a switch storage network topology. Let's move on and check the ACP Foundation software improvements. For day zero and day one operations, we have enhanced the automated cluster deployment wizard to support up to 16 compatible nodes. The nodes can be automatically discovered or manually added. If more than 16 nodes are selected, an error message pops up and the next button at the bottom remains grayed out to prevent you from proceeding until the issue is resolved. Additionally, we can now leverage the JSON file upload feature to simplify the cluster configuration process. After the file is loaded, all the fields are automatically filled. For security reasons, the JSON configuration file will not include passwords. You must manually enter and verify any passwords. After the configuration is validated, you can download the new JSON configuration file to reuse for future deployments and then click Deploy Configuration. In the future, we're planning to enhance the JSON file upload feature by adding support configuration files generated from the configuration portal. This release introduces the RESTful API for day one operations. This means that now there are two options to deploy a cluster: the UI-based deployment wizard mentioned before, or the RESTful API for performing the two main day one operations: installing Azure Stack HCI OS and deploying the cluster. It basically consists of the following steps: power on the MC nodes, which come with the Bootstrap OS factory installed, auto-discover the MC nodes, install Azure Stack HCI OS on the MC nodes, deploy the cluster. At any moment, you can check the status of the different actions. This simple and effective process helps eliminate risk by bringing up many clusters in a repeatable and consistent manner. For day two operations, we have developed two new GUI-based capabilities: a GUI workflow for drive, add, or replace, and a GUI workflow for node repair or replace. Both GUIs walk you through workflow-based wizards where all the validations, checks, recommendations, and verifications take place so you can perform the final operations sequentially. It is important to note that as of today, Dell services are required to perform any of the operations that require a node reimage process, such as a cluster deployment, a node repair or replace, or a node add. The last section of this video covers our newest integrations with several parts of the platform. First, and on the serviceability front, we've added embedded service enabler and remote secure credential logs to the standard log bundle collection process. Starting with this ACP release, logs related to RSC and ESE will be collected from the Apex Cloud Platform Manager VM and added to the standard logs bundle, which is then downloadable from the Apex Cloud Platform extension in WAC. No need to log into the ACP Manager VM and collect the logs manually from their respective folders anymore. As part of this update, we also provide integration with Azure Update Manager to deliver easier lifecycle management at scale and to stay current with monthly quality and security updates for multiple ACP for Azure clusters. Guardrails are implemented to prevent applying baseline bundle updates to Apex Cloud Platform for Azure. The ability to install baseline bundles containing Dell hardware updates, BIOS, iDRAC, firmware, and drivers is planned for a future release of the platform. Lastly, we have just released event monitoring for Dell Apex Cloud Platform for Microsoft Azure. Dell has created and customized Azure Workbook seamlessly integrated with insights in Azure Portal to monitor real-time faults and events generated by the MC-HCI node hardware and the Cloud Platform Manager VM. This delivers a comprehensive view of cluster health, node status, and alerts through Azure Monitor Service. This concludes what is new for Dell Apex Cloud Platform for Microsoft Azure early March release. Stay tuned for more training updates in InfoHub, and thanks for watching.